Hi, it's Evan here from Plain Jane. So today, I'm going to keep it pretty short. It's Sunday, there's football, but there's also going to be some high-level content. I'm going to be talking about why you can see such really widely varying lab tests for the exact same flower. This is something that's pretty well known in the industry to happen. You test your flower with one lab, it shows one number. You test your lab with another lab, it shows a different number. I don't know how common this knowledge is in general, but I just kind of wanted to put it out there, let you guys know about it, and kind of explain why it's happening. So the first thing is this is our Electra, right? This is our CBD hemp flower Electra. It's our biggest, most popular strain. Shows 14.5%. Awesome, super nose, seems like super potent, seems like a really great flower. Yeah, and that seems like, maybe a little bit low, but a pretty reasonable number, 14.5%. We wanted to see, hey, like, if we sent it to another lab, would we get a similar number? You always want to be double checking. So we sent this exact same strain, right, to another lab. This one, I'm going to have ton of stuff redacted because I'm not trying to call anyone out. I just want to kind of show what's happening. And really, when we get to explaining why the numbers are so different, you're going to see it's not really like, as long as a lab produces a consistent number, that's all that matters. The actual numbers, right, as long as they're following the regulations and they're doing everything, it helps to be an informed buyer, but a lab's job is to be consistent. So if they have different procedures that result in slightly different numbers, hey, it's okay. So the thing is, I want to point out, this is the lab test on the left. This one is exactly the same flower. It basically came from the same bin, harvested at the same time. It's not like it sat in the ground longer. Nothing, at least on our side going on. We have another lab test that you'll see on the right. It's slightly different. I'll talk about that one in a moment, but I want you to focus on the left. So if you look at the one on the left, you're going to see that basically the numbers are so much higher, right? The lab test that we have on our website, it shows 14.6% CBD. This one here, the one on the left, it shows, let's look at the converted total here, it is nearly 23%, right? There's, I mean, it's almost 9% extra CBD. That's a crazy difference. That's a really, really high difference. But, that's kind of the name of how different labs work, right? Different labs have different procedures, and we'll talk about this more later. But as a company, when we get like, I mean, I could put either of these lab tests on the website and say, hey, these are like real labs. These labs are certified. Generally, we choose to go with the lower one because it will be more realistic if you test it yourself. We're kind of always safe. But you also have to be careful. There are some labs, I don't think Evio is one of them, that their numbers are artificially low just because their testing procedures are bad, right? So if you see a number that's crazy different, it's not necessarily one lab is doing something. It could be the other lab just isn't doing a great job. And we'll really dive into the procedures in a moment here. The second thing I want to point out is that the lab test here on the right, it was done on Electra as well. But this was different flower. So it was in the ground a different amount of time, and it was also dried in a kiln. So where most of our flower is hang dried and everything like that, on some of the wholesale side, people look for kiln dried flower. They don't care as much about the terpenes. They're more focused on just getting something with a super high CBD content, and maybe they're going to use it for extraction or something like, or some sort of live rosin or other sort of product. The thing here to notice is that it also has a really big difference. It's slightly lower than the other one, which is what we expect, right? These numbers make sense in context with each other, right? This one here should be lower than this one here. They're pretty close. It's, the same strain. Maybe this one is a little too close because it was in the ground a little bit longer, but it was also planted a little bit later. So it's kind of harder to tell. These numbers are close. They're not too far apart. They make sense. The lab is consistent. So when I said the lab on the right was kiln dried, what did I mean? I mean, it's basically put on a conveyor and it has heat dried on it. Why do we dry anything this way? really the only reason is we run out of drying space. Sometimes late in the season, if the rains are delaying the drying, which is happening, it's happening right now actually. Stuff takes a little longer to dry. We don't have as much space as we thought we would. We still want to get the flower out of the ground. We don't want it to mold, so we have to dry it very quickly. First thing that I ask when I see numbers that are so different is, what was the trim job on it? Because the first thing in sample preparation is, does something look like this, or does it look more like the one on the left? If something looks like the one on the left here, it's going to have higher numbers. It can be the same strain harvested at the same time. Different labs actually have different procedures. So I called the lab that had the higher numbers and I tried to understand their process to say, hey, what are you guys doing? We tested with Evio and we got these numbers. We tested with you guys and we got pretty different numbers. So can you explain? A big thing that they said is they really make sure the sample is trimmed properly. If you give them something that looks like this, they're going to test something that looks like this. And if you look at our Evio sample here that we have a picture of, you can see that it's really not trimmed perfectly, right? So maybe if we would have trimmed the samples perfectly before getting this lab test, it would have been a lot higher. Maybe not 8 or 9% higher, but it would have been closer. The next reason that really happens of why the numbers can be different is lab tests use different solutions. So the way that the lab test works is you actually grind up your sample and you dissolve it in something. Different labs have different solutions. This is really hard to tell because different labs use different proprietary solutions. So you don't necessarily have the specs on everything, but it could be a cause of difference, right? So labs are just operating fine. They're just using different solutions. Different solutions are better or worse at extracting the CBD from the plant material, and thus, if it's better or worse, that'll actually affect the numbers that you see. Part is other testing procedures and the equipment you use. This generally isn't a big point of variance, but it can be sometimes. There's only a few companies that actually make this really expensive, high quality, high throughput machinery that these accredited laboratories must use. So the specs aren't going to be too different. But the procedures and the machinery and combined, these can also have an impact on the numbers. That's kind of the end of what I wanted to explain. Hopefully this was informative. Really, what I want you to do is kind of set benchmarks for yourself. What I do if I get, a lab test from a lab I don't know, I try to find what I think is a standard candle. So I know like the Electra strain really well because it's our most popular strain. It's also grown by a good amount of other people. So I can kind of see, understand where the numbers should be. And that's how I kind of figure out what a lab is doing and what I would expect from, various labs. Hopefully this is informative. I hope you learned something. If you have any questions, let me know. I'm going to be showing you other things about lab tests more in the future. There's more to come. This is just the first one. Have a good Sunday. I'll see you guys later.